First of all, we're thrilled to be back in the NCAA tournament. Certainly has been an exciting and amazing ride for our young ladies. I want to welcome all the other teams since we are the host. The pressure was getting back here, and now that we're here, we just want to play as well as we possibly can play at our university and in front of our fans. It's been a great year. We were undefeated in our conference play, won the conference championship, and just really looking forward to the game tomorrow and playing a very good West Virginia team. And I know the young ladies to my right, you know, are just really, really excited about the opportunity to play back in the NCAA tournament.
The team was excited when we did find out about coming back here to have the chance to play in the NCAA tournament, but getting back here was, it was in the back of our minds, but the way we took our season was one game at a time, and we set goals in the beginning of the season, so we went one goal at a time, and this was our long-term goal, and we were able to get here.
I think it's great coming into this tournament, being veterans, being older players, having been here in this tournament last year. Last year, we were a little more shocked at the whole atmosphere, and this year, I think we're a lot more calm and focused, so we're way more focused on just the game plan and one game at a time. So I think it's huge that we have the experience this year and the age to carry us through, and we've also had some really tough games this season, so when things haven't gone our way, we've worked through adversity and gotten wins, so I think we'll definitely be able to work on that and just use that as motivation to keep us going. I definitely think they have a great defense. They like to pressure teams a lot, so we need to be able to handle the pressure and still get into our offenses. I think that's going to be the biggest thing tomorrow, is getting past that pressure and being able to get open and still run our offenses. We don't want to let them take us out of our game.
Kim is our spark plug. You know, she gives us speed. Her speed will be important tomorrow against West Virginia's speed. She is a young lady that is a penetrator, has a very nice pull-up mid-range game, and she was looking for a home where she could be a starter, where she could make an impact, and she certainly has done that here at Delaware. She changes the tempo for us at times. Sometimes I want to slow her down because she does speed up a little bit too much, but she gives us an element of speed that we did not have at Delaware. I don't think there's any kind of bad blood or anything like that between Akima and West Virginia. She was thankful to go there and have that experience. She just felt like after the time there that she would find a home where it would fit maybe her talents, and Delaware was that home for her, and we welcomed her with open arms, and certainly it has paid dividends for her and for our program. First of all, the community and the fans of Delaware have been incredible. You know, they have embraced women's college basketball, and I think they're thrilled for us, of course, but also just to have these other quality teams here. North Carolina, West Virginia, and Albany, all very good teams and have obviously accomplished a lot to get here. I expect it to be electric. I expect it to be people really into every play. It should be very loud in the Bob Carpenter Center. You know, it's a great facility for women's college basketball because, you know, it's not overly huge, and it's 5,000 seats, and every seat will be filled, and I'm sure there'll be some standing room only people as well.
I walked into class to applause. Akima and I actually, we had the same class Monday morning, and our classmates clapped for us. Our professor gave us hugs. In my other class, our professor was talking about us winning the championship and things, and they're just ready for Sunday and Tuesday.
Hopefully we'll play well, and so will the other teams, and we'll all put on a really good show for this community, because hosting something like this is special. It doesn't come around all the time, and for the state of Delaware, for the community of Newark, it's just a wonderful happening.
Elena, besides her stats, like, she's able to find people on the, you know, cutting back door. She's able to get the ball to people. She's definitely a team player. You know, she gives us all those pep talks and games, and if she ever feels like, you know, we're getting down on ourselves, she's that person to pick us up and tell us that, you know, we're going to overcome, we're going to pull this out, we have to stay together.
Just to go off of what Parker said, Elena's, it's not only what she does scoring the ball and defensively, it's how she makes everyone around her on the team better, and she just has, when she gets emotional on the court, it just gets us that much more excited. And she does all the little things. Everything might not come up on the stat sheet that she does, but she does all the little things that help keep this team together.
Elena is a special talent. There's no doubt about it. But I think even more importantly, I've coached some really good players previous to this, but no one has put their ego aside, like Elena has put her ego aside. And this team really does feel like a sisterhood. You know, she understands that it's 1 through 15, 1 through 16. She understands that everybody's role is important. She doesn't make herself feel any more important than anybody else. And that is the true greatness of Elena. When she's your teammate, she is your teammate. As far as skill set and all of that, Elena ranks all the way at the top. And I'm grateful that I coached her. I know she's ready to fly and spread her wings now after this tournament certainly is over, whenever that may be.
Coming off of my first year playing 8 games and having an injury and then, you know, making such an impact in this program and being in the 1,000-point rebound club, it definitely shows that I have passion and I've overcome many obstacles. Elena and I talk about it all the time that it's a blessing that I got hurt my first year because we're able to play together our final year and we've made such an impact.
When I walk away from this from years from now, certainly I'll remember Elena, but honestly, it's going to be the group that I remember. It really truly is. And that's why I think it's made Elena special, because she's made it about the group. And so I will remember all of my kids.
It's great to have this group going out, 7 seniors, and we all have definitely come together. I'm happy. I feel like I had a great 5 years here, and I'm just ready to continue on this journey in the NCAA tournament.